阿弥陀佛。Good evening, everyone. 师父上人，各位师兄，大家阿弥陀佛。Venerable Master, Dharma friends, good evening and good afternoon. My name is Hung Shur. This is the Sunday night evening Buddha Hall lecture at City of 10,000 Buddhas. And if you have joined us, welcome.欢迎大家参加我们的星期天晚上万佛上乘佛教讲解开示讲经法会。This is the 26th observance of the Nirvana of our teacher, our founder, 上宣下化。Venerable Master Xuan Hua. And tonight I have the privilege of sharing with four other speakers our reflections on our teacher and also some new progress in our effort to capture his life both in print and also.On the screen. 今天晚上大家集会。过玄公上人第26涅槃日。今天恒时恭信有另外四位四中弟子的代表来跟我一起分享他们对于我们法界佛教总会万佛上乘法界大学这个创办人玄公上人来我们等一等代表四中弟子这个各有自己不同的感想自己的报道新的有所进步在我们要记载玄公上人的外传所以呢今天晚上我们的节目就这样子那么还没有开始之前我们先要请法那请法的仪式呢我来分享我的荧幕we're going to begin with a Dharma request, and in order to request Dharma, I'm going to share my screen so people can make the Dharma request along with me. Here we are. All right, here is ourDharma request, and I will put my palms together and invite our Dharma requester to make his request. 好，请开始。
恭请大德圣听为此法会及一切众生请转妙法轮教导我们如何了生脱死离苦得乐殊胜无生 Well, the Sangha with great virtue out of compassion for the sake of this assembly and all living beings, Please turn the wonderful Dharma wheel to teach us how to leave suffering and attain bliss and end birth and death and quickly realize numbers.
Namo tassa bhagavato arahato samma sambuddhassa.
Namo tassa bhagavato arahato samma sambuddhassa.
Homage to the blessed, noble, and perfectly enlightened one.
Homage to the blessed, noble, and perfectly enlightened one.
Namo sadanto sucedoye alahudi samyao sanputoshi.
Namo sadanto sucedoye alahudi samyao sanputoshi.
Wu shang shen shen wei miao fa, bai qian wan jie nan zao yu, wo jin jian wan de shou shi, yuan jie ru lai zhen shi yi. Supreme and wondrous Dharma, subtle and profound, rarely is encountered even in billions of eons. But now we see and hear it and accept it reverently. May we truly understand the Buddha's actual meaning. 那师父上人, 各位师兄, Venerable Master, Dharma friends, it is indeed my pleasure. I'm going to stop sharing my screen. I want to thank Alan for the Dharma request. Appreciate the opportunity to be with you this evening and this afternoon. This is, as I said, Master Hua's 26th observance of his entering Nirvana. And when we look at the life of a teacher like this, it's a big project to capture it and to find the real essence of what he taught and what influence he had. But tonight, I'm going to introduce our attempt to do that and say a few words. Then I'm going to invite Dharma Master Heng Yin. I'm sorry, I'll start first with Dharma Master Jin Chuan. Jin Chuan is going to speak as a representative of the Bhikshu Sangha, but a generation, the Jin Zibei, the Jin generation instead of the Heng generation, who didn't personally have a chance to meet with Master Hua, but who nonetheless has been profoundly influenced by his teachings. And Jin Chuan sure has been active in the efforts to capture the biography of Master Hua to share it with others. So he will speak first. Following that, we're going to both invite Dharma Master Heng Yin, Dharma Bhikshuni Heng Yin, who is again a representative of the Bhikshuni Sangha, and yet she is also from the Heng generation. She was personally influenced by Master Hua to leave the home life and commit her life to cultivating the Dharma. So Dharma Master Heng Yin is going to share her reflections about her teacher's influence. Following that, I'm going to ask Madalena Tan, Tan Mujie, Tan Guoshi, to speak on behalf of the Lay Women's Sangha, also a senior disciple who took refuge with Master Hua at age 11, and that was a few years ago. She's going to talk to us about the efforts to propagate, to share, to spread the teachings of the Dharma in China. And there's some remarkable news about that, those efforts. And then after we hear from Madalena, we're going to ask Alex Wong to close the evening and share with us his perspective as a layman, but also much younger than some of us, someone who represents youth as well, who found in Master Hua's messages and his teaching of the Dharma something very compelling, something that he found himself hungry for, that he wanted to learn more about. So we have five speakers, myself, G. Jinchuan, Hengyin, Madalena, and then Alex. Then if we have any time left, we'll see how the time goes. We may have chance for some questions. And we also want to mention to everyone that there will be a chance to join in our biography efforts at the end. We'll let you know if this is something that you would like to share. We're going to tell you how to do that. Also, I want to mention that if you would like to hear a Vietnamese translation tonight, we will be speaking in English and in Chinese. If you would like to hear a Vietnamese translation, go to your chat box. You have a chat function on your screen there, and you can tune into a separate Vietnamese translation Zoom channel. All right? All right. Now, we'll just show.那我就我先讲几句话，我恒时，然后介绍今天晚上的节目。然后呢，我们就请进传法师，他是美国土生的中国人，他也是亲自被，他没有亲自依照玄公上人，不过呢，他知道上人的法，他就想把身心性命托给佛教。 那么他代表比丘僧，讲他为什么他很热心地参加这个积极玄公上人的外传这个工作。那么，君传法师讲完了之后呢，我们就请恒音比丘尼，恒音师他是恒字辈，他因为遇到玄公上人，他在读大学的时候就完全改变他生命的方向。 就出了家做比丘尼，那么他也会讲他的感想啊。那么第三位呢，第四位就是 Madalena 塔木杰唐果师，他呢11岁的时候在香港就先皈依玄公上人，然后呢他先到美国来，他跟他姐姐那么。 Stella， 他们两位呢，就请先写那个最早的那个请帖请玄公上人到美国来了，所以呢，他要代表女居士，就是优婆夷这个团，就是四众弟子里面那个女居士，他就代表告诉我们，现在在中国用了新的科技的发展来介绍。 玄华上人的开示，他的法语啊，这是很有，我相信大家都会很感兴趣听到，Madalena 他要跟大家分享，尤其你会用手机用这个 WeChat 那个 APP 那个 App， 就是有新的消息了哈。那我们最后呢，有一位男居士，他是 Alex Wang， 他呢，虽然年轻了，他就。 知道玄华上人就所讲的经说的法，他也很发心，那么跟随就研究佛法，知道自己到这个世界来是为了什么，他就对于佛法非常感兴趣了啊，所以呢，他要讲他对于玄公上人呢这个 biography project 的感想。 然后我们就请Alan Huang 来帮Alex 来翻译中文。Okay, so that is our program. Sorry for my broken Chinese. I hope you all can be patient with me. So here's the idea. This is what I wanted to share. We have Master Hua's biography in Manchuria, 杜伦禅师事迹. That's been published for decades. We have the story of Master Hua's time, his 10 years in Hong Kong. That has been published in Chinese, a beautiful book. The Cihang Du Xiangjiang, right? It's a wonderful book and lots of, let's see, volume is very soft. Please increase the volume. Oh my goodness, okay. I will certainly do that. Is that any better? Can everybody hear? Is anybody else having trouble with my volume? What can we do about that?
It's fine.
It's good? Okay, thank you. Thank you. Okay. So the Chinese biography has been published, but from 1961, when Shifu left Australia, returned to Hong Kong, and then came to America, that story, those stories, have yet to be told. So it's up to us, our generation now, to share our teacher's vows, his practices, his expedient skill in teaching with the world. And I'm happy to say that we've been working on this project for quite a while. We have a strong team of people who are contributing. And not only do we have a book in the works, but we also have a movie. We have a documentary, a video, which is in progress right now, which will also help tell the story of our teacher's life in America. 那就说玄公上人他在东北的时候已经很久有一部叫杜伦禅师事迹就讲解师父在中国那个时候就一直到离开中国去香港那个时候已经出版了然后呢最近出来有另外一本就是师父十年在香港那个时候就整个的名字叫 什么什么慈航渡香江，我总是搞不清楚啊。那个那本非常好，有很多相片啊，那些故事呢，讲的就是亲自亲眼看到师父在香港的时候的人在那儿奇迹，那本已经出来了，还没有翻译英文，希望没有多久了，我们都可以有双语的啊，师父在香港的 外传，可是呢，师父离开澳大利亚1961年回去香港，然后到美国来，从1961年到1995年了，师父入涅槃，啊，觉海慈航渡湘江，谢谢，觉海慈航渡湘江，那是那个香港那个那本的正式的名字。那么那些故事呢还没讲，还没有写。 更没有电影哈，那么现在我们已经有 committee 来发行把这个那本书师父在西方的外传要把它集结了要把它整理啊，另外呢我们现在有一篇电影都要现在在这排在这编辑了，所以呢我们希望不久的将来 都可以把这些故事讲好了。那么, let's take a look now. Here's how we're thinking about the biography. And this is our current thinking on it. Most of the time, if you're looking at the life of an important figure, it's entirely looking back. You turn your head to, it's a historical book. Certainly, with Master Hua, because his life involved so many activities and so many people, his vows were so big, so vast, that we can't only look back, we also have to look ahead to see the progress of the seeds that he planted. So here's how we're thinking about this project. I'll just give the outline, and then I'm going to invite Jin Chuan Shi to speak. The outline looks like this. We're going to have a timeline. In Chinese, they call it a nianpu, right? A timeline is events. When Shifu was born, we're going to look back to briefly to Manchuria to Hong Kong, and then bring it up to 1961, when he arrived in the US in 62. And then who Shifu met, where he was, the monasteries he created, etc. That's a timeline, and that's precise events. That's a historical indisputable fact, right? So that's the first piece. The second piece that we're looking at is Master Hua's influence on people. And since 2003, we initiated our first oral history project. And the Oral History Project grew and grew and grew. We've been gathering interviews and taping them. And so now we have quite a database of powerful interviews that tell the influence of a true Shan Zhishi, a Kalyana Mitra, a good and wise teacher, on our lives. So from those interviews, we are selecting stories and testimonies about how Shifu's meeting this teacher put our lives on the right track and inspired us to become better people, ultimately to become Buddhas and Bodhisattvas, ideally, right? So that's the second piece. The third piece, once we started it, oh my goodness, this got bigger and bigger and bigger. And this third piece was Master Hua's influence on the times, on the world around him, how one monk's life could change the events of the time. And as we think about that, we think of four legacies. The four legacies are Master Hua's creation of the Buddhist Sangha, because in America, Buddhism was the new religion on the block, right? And nobody had seen a Buddhist bhikshu or a bhikshuni or an upasika or an upasika, right? We didn't know how to be monks, nuns, laymen, laywomen. Furthermore, there were no buildings, no monasteries to house the monastic sangha. So Master Hua created the sangha and the place for the sangha to live. Furthermore, he told us, he modeled for us the correct deportment and behavior of monks, nuns, laymen, and laywomen. That's the first legacy. Second legacy is Master Hua's teaching of the Dharma, particularly explaining sutras. And we didn't know that it wasn't every single monk who explained sutras every single night. We thought that's what everyone did. And it was in fact unique to Shifu to take 90 minutes of every night that he was alive in America and speak the Dharma, jiang jing shuo fa, right? He did that. He turned the Dharma wheel. He lectured and presented, gave us the gift of Mahayana sutras, including one in particular, the Avatamsaka Sutra, took 9 years to lecture completely. So we, the next generations of disciples, have endeavored to translate the lectures that Master Hua gave on the Mahayana text. That's the second legacy. The third legacy is education. Master Hua's practice was, wherever there's a classroom, there's going to be, wherever there's a Buddha hall, there's going to be a classroom. Schools popped up, especially at City of 10,000 Buddhas, but in many branches, including Dharma Realm Buddhist University, instilling virtue, cultivating goodness, elementary and secondary schools. And this legacy of education stemmed from his own practice of lifelong learning, huo da lao, xue da lao. That was truly his practice, a fascination with the world and with the living beings in it so that he could teach us, right? Then the fourth one, and I will translate in a minute. The fourth one of those legacies is legacy called, we're calling interfaith and intrafaith. Interfaith is more than religions talking to religions, right? Master Hua also wanted the teachings of the Dharma to talk to science, to talk to politics, to talk to governments, to talk to education, to talk to working people, so that we could look into the mirror of the Buddha's wisdom and find guidelines for living our lives. That was the real interfaith for Master Hua. And furthermore, there's another piece to interfaith, which is intra-faith, and that is Buddhists talking to Buddhists. One of the delights of our lives, our generation, is our brothership, is our kinship and our brotherhood with the monks of the Theravada tradition, of particularly with the lineage of Ajahn Chah and the forest monks of Thailand, but also brotherhood with other monastics, with Roman Catholic monks, the Benedictines and the Trappists, and also the Swamis of the Ramakrishna Mission and the Vedanta Society. So the disciples of Sri Ramakrishna. So we are delighted. We're so, our lives as monks has interfaith and intrafaith built in, thanks to our teacher's vision. So along with those four legacies comes a vast number of things like filiality, eating a plant-based vegan diet, learning to talk to people of all walks of life, creating new holidays, cherishing elders, respecting elders, cherishing youth, entire holidays, completely innovative by Master Hua. So as we looked into that third piece of our biography, it grew and grew and grew. So we have a big job ahead of us, but that's the outline. So let me translate that, and that's my portion of tonight's program.
我们现在就知道一般这个大的高僧就圆寂入涅槃之后呢完全是往头把头往后转看后边历史书那么像玄公上人师父上人这种的生活这么大的这个规模心量那么大的一个大的高僧他所种下的种子现在就开花结果 所以我们都要往前看，这种的，这是外传，他的biography， 不能完全往后说他过去怎么样，一定要看现在未来这个发展，你才能完整的看这么一个，这是一个开荒的一个大的。 所以呢，我们用这种眼光来把这个工作呢，就说整理师父的外传，他的传记，就现在分三个部分。第一呢，是他的年谱，年谱是说哪一年，到哪里去啊，看什么人，说什么话，做什么事，那就是事实了，facts 就肯定一定的，那就要整理，要正确。第二呢，就是上人所认识的人，他影响多少人，遇到这个人呢，跟他讲话，那么把这个人的生命的方向就往好了转。这样子呢，就很多。所以从2003年开始，我们的口述历史（ （Oral History Project） 现在这个archive 很多。 那么第三个部分呢，第三个部分就是我们的这个所谓四大遗产，就包括什么建立僧团，还有就是讲经说法、法尼经典，第三呢，第三就是整理改革教育，就是推行教育，第四个呢就是宗教交流。 这四个呢，这个第三个部分呢，包括四个所谓四大遗产，这个是玄公上人他在时代的影响，这么一个眼光啊，这么范围这么大的一个这么广泛的一个创办人呢，这么一个法师啊，他呢。 我们一开始记录下来了，哇，这个题目呢变成很大，所以等一等，我们再有机会，我都翻译出来这个更详细我所介绍的第三个部分。OK， 因为我们还有四位都要讲话，所以呢我自己就到此为止，我就请金川法师就。So I need to stop so that we can have plenty of time to listen to all our other speakers. I would like to ask Jinchuan Shi to please continue and share with us what he would like to give us tonight.
Good evening, everyone. We'll just start in the kind of traditional way we do at CDTV. All Buddhas and Bodhisattvas, Venerable Master, Dharma Master is present, and all good and wise friends online, Amitofo. Good evening. I'm honored to be able to be here with everyone and to have a chance to express my gratitude for the Venerable Master, his early disciples, and everyone who contributed to creating this Dharma field that I have the blessings to be part of. As we know, this work is ongoing, day by day, moment by moment. But in my heart, every day when I wake up, I have a deep appreciation for this opportunity to live the spiritual life, the monastic life in Master Hua's lineage. And as I was reflecting on how to share tonight, I thought of writing a letter of gratitude to Master Hua. So that's the form it'll take. Dear Venerable Master, you have left your physical body for 26 years now. But for me, your presence still lives on in many ways. In the monasteries that you have established, in the teachings that you have given, and perhaps most importantly, in the hearts and minds of your disciples. I'm deeply grateful for your kindness. It manifests as the daily sustenance I receive every day, the sense of spiritual direction and meaning, and the community of good and wise advisors, mentors, and friends. I would like to especially reflect on three areas that have made a deep impact on my life. The first is your teachings on the mind ground, that Buddhism is not locked into any cultural form, be it Chinese, Indian, or even American. It goes to the root of the mind. That teaching helps me as an ABC, an American-born Chinese, having grown up in two different cultures, one Chinese and one American. Naturally, there are internal tensions between the two cultures in me. And over the past few decades in DRBA, I found that I've slowly begun to heal these conflicts in myself. One example of this is learning from one of your early disciples, Reverend Hung Shir, who just spoke. I remember as a young man wanting to be a monk, having decided that this is my path in life. But this actually created a lot of tension in my family, especially with my mom, who didn't understand what I was doing. She was afraid I might be going down the wrong path, or maybe just simply naive. At that time, however, I was determined to leave home. I remember going to your disciple and asking honestly from the depth of my heart, what should I do in this life? Surprisingly, his answer to me was to listen to my mom more. To me, that was rather unexpected because I wanted to be a monk. And my mom opposed it. So what should I do? After some reflection, I decided to follow his advice. And I slowly began to be a better son in the family, responding when they called, listening to their guidance, helping out more around the house. And as the years progressed, I found that my relationship with both my parents improved. And when it came time finally to leave home in DRBA, they were both supportive. Although it took 10 years, it was definitely worth it. I learned that being independent, which is a strong ideal in the West, and filial, that comes from our Chinese cultural roots, are not in opposition, but they can go hand in hand. I appreciate this teaching from you on filiality as it comes down through your disciples. You yourself set the example by bowing to your parents and waiting until after your mother's passing to leave home because of her wishes. The second area that I'm deeply appreciative of is your open heart and open mind, healing long-standing divides. Reverend Hung Shir just spoke about that, about interfaith and intrafaith. You laid the foundation for a deep friendship between the Theravada and Mahayana Buddhist traditions. For myself, much of my inspiration to cultivate comes from the teachings of Ajahn Sumedho, who you considered a fellow Dharma practitioner from past lives. You deeply respected the Thai forest tradition's devotion to the Vinaya, and even gave them 120 acres of land to start a Bhayagiri monastery. As part of the next generation of monastics, I feel honored to have their community as good spiritual friends. There's no divide. We are very much united in heart and spirit, following the Buddha's teachings of liberation together. Lastly and thirdly, I'm grateful for the opportunity to get an education grounded in virtue that brings together study and practice. Study itself is practice, and practice itself is a study of the mind and heart. You set up many educational institutions, instilling goodness and developing virtue schools, the Sangha and Lady training programs, Dharma Realm Buddhist University. What I truly treasure is your example of a love of learning in service to others for self-transformation. Education is cultivation. Cultivation is education. Over the years, I had the opportunity to work at DRBU as well as be a monk in DRBA. I found that they mutually complement each other. The monastic form allows for a depth of stillness and reflection. The shared inquiry in DRBU brings a living dialogue into the process. Form and spirit, spirit and form. Together, they allow me to explore my mind and heart beyond categories of Asian and American to the visions of Theravada and Mahayana and the possible split between study and practice. For all these things and many more, I'm deeply grateful. My left home name is Jing Chuan. Chuan literally translates to carry on, to transmit, to pass along. And that's what I wish to dedicate my life to carrying on, to passing on something that I deeply treasure, that has touched my own heart, and has a purity and depth that is far beyond my understanding. Something I feel extremely blessed to be part of. Master Hua, 26 years after your passing, I hope to be a good disciple. Bowing in respect, Jing Chuan.
好，先我自己帮自己翻译中文。好，诸佛菩萨、上人、法师、各位善知识，阿弥陀佛。今晚我想表达我对上人。 早期弟子法总每一位的感恩心，每天早上起来，我心里充满的感恩，因为我有这个机会在上人的僧团出家。今晚我分享一个封信，就是感恩上人的一封信。所以上人，您离开我们了已经26年了，但是。 在您建立的道场，在您给我们的教导，还有您的弟子的修行榜样，我还感受您的存在。感恩的事情说不完，比如每天的饮食、生命的方向，在法总的各位善知识、老师、朋友。 但是我今晚想讲，就是今晚有三个地方，我想特别来讲的，对我有影响的。第一，就是您对心地的教导。你知道我们佛教不是限定在任何一个文化当中，没有一个就是中国佛教或者印度佛教。 甚至也没有个美国的佛教，佛教是的根就是我们修行我们的心。我是一个 ABC， 美国出生的中国人，所以自然的我心中会有美国和中国文化的一个冲突。但是在法总这20年，可以说慢慢的我的心可以说冲突可以回复。 这样子说，其中一个例子呢，就是我年轻的时候，跟您的早期弟子恒实法师学习。我年轻的时候想要出家，决定这个是我生命的一个道路，但是这个决定呢，令我家人非常不高兴，特别我的妈妈。 他害怕我走 错路，太天真。那时候我问了司法师，我的生命的道路是什么呢？他的答案令我很惊讶。他说，我要多听妈妈的话，多听母亲的话。我想象不到，因为我想我的妈妈不要我出家，我有这个心想出家怎么办呢？我回去想一想，最后就跟随上那个司法师的建议，我就努力当一个好孩子。父母叫我，我就马上回答，然后我尊重他们的建议，听他们的话，也多做家务。慢慢的，父亲母亲的这个关系改变好一点。到我决定真正出家的时候，他们支持。前后花了10年的时间，但决定是值得的。我学到独立和孝道，没有冲突，互相可以帮助。上人，我感恩你这个孝道的教导，传到从你的弟子到现在，也是你的榜样。礼拜父母，等你父母往生，母亲往生还出家，守孝等等。第二，我很感恩，就是你的这个心量。比方说，就是我们北传南传的这个分裂，你就把它恢复。我们在法种跟这个南传的阿姜伽泰国森林派的这个僧团是好朋友。我自己呢，对阿姜苏梅多非常尊重，学的从他学很多。那我听你讲，你就是他以前前身的一个同参道友，你也非常尊重他们守戒的这个戒律修行，甚至于给他们120英亩来建立无畏寺。我们两个僧团呢是好朋友，像Dharma Brothers 一样，一心来修行，跟着佛陀的教导。第三，是您提供这个道德教育。学习跟修行不是两回事，学习就是修行，修行就是学习，特别学习我们的心。您建立了很多教育的结构机构，比方说玉良小学、培德中学、成学知识训练班、法界大学，但是您教育的精神是真正有这个好学的精神，要利益众生的精神，改变我们自己这个修行的精神，这是对我最大的影响。变成怎么样呢？教育就是修行，修行就是教育。在过去几年呢，我有机会在法界大学工作，也就是一个法种的一个就说比丘出家。在这个两个身份呢，觉得互相配合很好，帮助互相帮助。作为一位出家人，我有机会深入修行，早课晚课等等。作为法大一个分子，也有机会来深入经藏学习。形式和精神，精神和形式，您建立的这个修行环境跟道风，让我观察我的内心，没有被文化，美国或中国的文化限制了，超越南传北传的分裂，也超越学习跟修行的分别。我感恩你的地方也有很多地方。我出家的名字是净传， 传有传有传承的意思，所以我自己就是想把我这个生命奉献，想传承你留给我们这个法宝，对我自己的生命非常大的影响，非常宝贵的。所以上人呢，您离开我们已经26年了，我希望当一个好弟子，顶礼上人，敬传。阿弥陀佛。
阿弥陀佛。All right. Your Chinese is much improved. My goodness.
I helped. I got help. I definitely got help from other people.
Yeah.
That was definitely not my ABC Chinese.
No, but it sounded good. Yeah. Okay. I wish. Yeah. Okay. I have to up my game too. My own Chinese. So. All right. Our third speaker tonight is Bikshuni Heng Yin, Guo Guan Heng Yin. Heng Yin Shi is one of the coordinators of the Bikshuni Sangha at JGH, Joyous Giving House at Wanfucheng. She's involved in pretty much all of our outward facing aspects of our life at CTDB and has including, I don't know if she's going to talk about it, but she was a major influence on bringing her own parents to City of 10,000 Buddhas, where Ray and Priscilla Ye have established themselves as the pillars of the lay community there. So talk about an accomplishment that I could hope for. The idea that my parents might move to City of 10,000 Buddhas, you know, it's just a dream, unrealized, but Bikshuni Heng Yin has manifested that. So I'm going to translate for myself and then invite Heng Yin Shi to share with us her thoughts on Shifu's 26th Nirvana and her relationship to her teacher. 接下来第三位呢是 Heng Yin Bikshuni, Guo Guan Heng Yin. 那么 Heng Yin Shi 在 Wanfucheng 是做这个领导作用，那么很多很多我们Wanfucheng 的从法尼经典一直到教育方面的Heng Yin Shi在参与哈。那么他呢有这些在佛法里边呢这些贡献呢不少，其中一个就是他把正法介绍的给他父母Ray and Priscilla， 甚至于父母呢就发心搬到万佛城来住，那么他的双亲都现在在圣城，他们做骑士团领导，那么这个能就是说杜父母啊，这是一个出家众所一个大目标啊，那么Heng Yin Shi已经成功了所以呢今天我请Heng Yin Shi跟大家分享他跟玄奘上人的关系已经26年这个涅槃日子的他的感想。好，请Heng Yin Shi，请你讲。
阿弥陀佛，师法师，上人，各位法师，各位善知识，阿弥陀佛。刚刚石法师的介绍真的是很不正确。在我的父母来圣城是跟我完全没有关系的，是他们自己的因缘，想要来圣城，然后学习佛法，所以我是很非常有福报，让说他们可以在圣城一起修行。但是跟我没有关系的。Okay, Venerable Master, Dharma Masters, and good advisors, 阿弥陀佛。Just wanted to correct one thing in the introduction that my parents coming to the City of 10,000 Buddhas really has nothing to do with me, and they have their own affinities, and I think next week they will have a chance to talk to explain their affinities too, but I'm very blessed that they are here and cultivating together. When I was asked to reflect on the Venerable Master's impact, the more I reflected, the more difficult it became to articulate anything. It felt like trying to put an ocean into a little few drops, but I'll try. It may be a little disorganized. So about 31 years ago, I was about to begin a PhD in computer science, and Master Hua and his disciples came to the university where I was. I heard the story Master told of how he bowed to his parents. And then I also learned from his disciples how to sit in meditation. These planted wholesome seeds in my heart. And so my first semester in grad school, I was studying computer science on the one hand and reading Shifu's sutra commentaries on the other. The master's simple yet wise words awakened in me a thirst to learn more. As for a career path, I asked myself, do I want to spend my time simulating the human mind on a computer, or do I want to truly understand my own mind? Inevitably, I was drawn to the city of 10,000 Buddhas like an iron filing to a magnet. And pretty soon I realized the monastic path was the only path for me if I really wanted to understand my mind. Fortunately, my parents have always been very open-minded and fully supported my decision despite being given very little time. In my experience, I agree with Jintran Shen. The master is still teaching and transforming living beings right now through the programs, the monasteries, and the schools that he has founded. Leaving home, I felt like a baby in the Dharma. Along with all my Dharma brothers, we have drunk the Dharma milk of Shifu's explanations of sutras, such as the Sharangama, the Lotus, the Avatamsaka. Through daily recitation and meditation, Dharma sessions, community work, translating, teaching in the school and university, we get to work closely with many different good-hearted people. Working with others, though, always challenges our own views and habits. Hopefully, it helps us to see and change our selfish tendencies. All around me, I see many disciples trying their best to keep alive what they learned from the master. And ultimately, we are all trying to understand who we really are, but this is really difficult. We tend to only know the surface of ourselves, the conscious mind. Sometimes we're taken aback by the powerful emotions and afflictions that arise. Without a supportive environment, we may abandon our original goal when it becomes too painful to see our own faults. Instead, we cover them up. If we forget our original resolve, it's easy to get caught up in rights and wrongs. That's when our good and wise advisors and Shifu's Dharma reminds us of our goal and sets us back on track. Shifu inspired us to get out of our comfort zone by his own example of selfless vigor. After a day of nonstop Dharma propagation that started in Burlingame and ended in Seattle, asked if he was tired, he said, "I never think about myself." His every interaction with living beings is trying to relate to their Buddha nature or showing them what's covering it up. So I'll give a few personal examples. Soon after I left home, someone was praising me to the master, saying, "Oh, she knows this and she knows that." And the master said, point blank, "I see that she knows how to eat." I was dumbfounded, as I was indeed struggling with desire for food while learning to eat one meal a day. Another time, I happened to walk past an open door and overhear a nun telling the master, "Han Yingshi said such and such." He immediately replied, "Han Yingshi? What does she know?" That certainly set me in my place. And once I became angry with a fellow nun over a publication issue. Soon afterwards, we received a phone call from the master who left this message. "If there is no fire in the liver, you can escape all disease. Such a wonderful cure-all medicine, set on the shelf and forgotten, Sopo He." In relation to my self-doubt, once I was supposed to translate for Shifu lecturing on the sutra, but I felt nervous. After he recited the first passage of sutra text, he paused for me to translate. Instead, I asked if he would explain first so that I could translate the text and the commentary afterwards and not make any mistakes. Shifu sighed and said, "You know, I threw up several times this morning, but I still came down to give the lecture to give you a chance to practice translating. since I'm doing my part, you should do your part. His words really made me ashamed, but at the same time gave me the courage to just try my best. And on guilt, after leaving home, we are always reflecting on our faults and repenting. And the more I reflected on my mistakes, the more terrible I felt. One day, the master announced that anyone who wished to could make an appointment to see him. Feeling very distressed, I went and I poured out all of my past misdeeds to Shifu. He smiled and said, "These are common mistakes in the world. You cannot change the past. However, I will take responsibility for all your past offenses. All you have to do is cultivate heart from now on. And don't hang your head. As a monastic, you have to stand tall and straight like a general." His words allowed me to truly begin anew and to have faith in myself. Even now, the master is here in the world if we take his teachings to heart. Anyone who wishes to understand the Buddha nature can dive into the master's Dharma. Okay, I'm going to just stop here and translate. And
我想了几天，然后觉得越来越不可能讲，因为呢太大了，好像一个大海，没有办法讲。但是呢，就讲一点。31年前，我开始要上博士班，在电脑系，上人跟他的弟子来到我的大学。 我就听到上人讲他小时候怎么样顶礼他的父母，然后呢，他弟子教我们怎么打坐，这些经验就种下一些善种子在我的心里。那我第一个学期在研究所，我一边学电脑系，一边就看上人的潜示。上人的又清楚又有智慧的潜示，就让我想要学习更多。 那我就问我自己，我想要花我的时间，用电脑来模仿人的心吗？还是我要去真正了解我自己的心？那幸亏我的父母是非常给我们自己做决定，然后呢也完全支持。虽然我没有给他们很多时间，那在我的经验，我觉得上人还是在教化众生，因为他已经设了这么多学校跟道场，有种种的课程，只要我们参与就可以得到上人的法。我刚出家就觉得像佛法里面的婴儿。 跟我的师兄弟一起，喝这个法乳，就是上人的潜示《楞严经》《法华经》《华严经》等，然后天天上殿打坐，参加法会，出坡翻译经典，在学校跟法大教书，可以跟很多善良的人一起合作，但是在合作当中，我们自己的 想法跟习气都会被挑战了，那希望我们就会看到我们自己的不对的地方，然后改变我们自己的自私心。我到处都看到上人的弟子在尽力的把上人所教他们的可以传下去。那我们毕竟也都是想要明心见性，可是这是非常难的。我们大部分只看得到我们 表面的我们的世心，那有时候会有很强的烦恼或者是感情生出来。如果我没有一个支持的这种环境，还有团体的话，我们可能就会放弃我们原来的目标或者发心，因为呢，看到我们自己的过错太痛苦了，我们就要把它盖过去。那如果忘了我们的初发心， 就很容易就参与是非。那个时候我们有一些善知识，同修道友，还有上人的看上人的法，就可以提醒我们自己回到正道上。那上人以身作则来启发我们走出这个舒适区。 所以我记得有一天他早上在 Burlingame 讲法，那晚上在 Seattle 传三归五戒然后讲法。有人问他累不累，他说我从来没有想过我自己。他每一个跟众生的互动都是要跟他们的佛性互动，或者是要给他们看你的佛性被什么遮盖了。那我就给一些、个人的例子。我刚出家不久，有一个人就在上人对上人、讲我会什么，我会这个，我会那个。那上人就说我看他会吃饭，然后我就心里就在很惊讶，因为呢我正在有这个挑战，有时就是很想吃东西，然后日中一时是很困难的。那另外一次我走过一个门、在房间里面听到有一个比丘尼在跟上人讲说恒应师说什么什么，那我就听到上人说恒应师他到底懂什么，所以呢这个就让我要谦虚一点。然后另外一次我跟一个同参对，就是不高兴，因为呢我们在关于出版的事情不同意，所以呢不久有一点脾气，不久以后就得到上人的电话留话说，肝中若无火，合并都能躲，即此妙切陀，一杯直高阁娑婆诃。所以我们心里不高兴他都也知道了。那有一次我是要应该要帮上人翻译讲经，但是我很紧张，所以上人念完了一段经文等我翻译的时候，我说可不可以请上人先讲完解释完我再翻译，我再才确定那个意思是什么。那上人就叹了一口气说，你知道吗，我今天早上吐了好几次，但是我还是下来讲经，因为要为了要让你练习翻译，因为我我尽了一份，那请你也尽你，让我很惭愧，但是也让我鼓励我有勇气去做。还有出家以后就是常常要回光返照看自己的错误，那越看越多就觉得越难过。那有一天上人在东岸说谁要跟他见面都可以约，那我就非常忧虑的，我就去跟他讲我过去做了什么错的事情。那上人就微笑说，这些都是很普通的，在世界上你不能改变过去，但是呢我会负责你所有过去这些过错，那你就好好的努力往前去修行，还有不要垂头丧气。我们出家人要顶天立地，像个将军，所以呢他讲这个话就让我可以真正的改过自新，然后对自己有信心。那上人现在都，如果我们诚心的跟着上人的依着上人的法去修行的话，上人真的还在。谁愿意的话都可以去学习上人的佛法，来认识我们自己的佛性。我现在就在这里听，因为时间不多了。阿弥陀佛。
阿弥陀佛。Okay, appreciate those great stories. Also, next week we're going to get a chance to listen to Dharma Master Yin's parents, Ray and Priscilla Ye, on Saturday evening. At what time? What time are the talks?
4 p.m.
4 p.m. California time. It's called Wo De Shifu, My Teacher Series. So looking forward to that. All right, Dharma Master Yin, gratitude, Amitofo. Next, I would like to introduce our speaker, Madalena Tam, Tamu Jie, Tangwo Shi. Madalena, as I mentioned, is a longtime disciple of Master Hua and made her own vows to help take the Dharma to China, to take Shifu's audio talks and his printed talks, put them into simplified characters, gather a large team of volunteers in China who are very enthusiastic, very sincere in their wish to draw near Shifu's teachings. And she has organized a lot of that effort. So she also has some brand new news for us. And I might also mention that Madalena has been central in putting together the movie, our documentary on Shifu's life. So let me translate for myself and then ask Madalena to share. 那么接下来呢，我们就请唐木杰唐居士，这个唐国师，他要跟大家讲，他把师父所讲的法，他的中文的录音，还有他的开示啊，他的讲经的注解等等，把它先翻译简体字。 然后在WeChat 在微信那里就出版在中国，他呢有一些很诚心、很热心修行的弟子啊，应该不能够说是师父的弟子，是唐木杰的义工，就是这么说，他们来发心就整理这个微信。 懂得怎么样在国内、在中国流通这些法音，所以今天 Madalena 还有一些新的消息跟我们分享。So could I invite Madalena, please, to share with us what you'd like to talk today on Shifu's 26th anniversary of his Nirvana. There she is.
Amitabha, Goei Fasi, Goei Jisi, Jintiana, 我可大家只是讲一讲，在中国，我们关于玄化上人的法在中国的情况，可能有很多人就觉得好奇怪，为什么我要把上人的法传到中国呢？其实。 这是因为在师父没有入涅槃之前，他就说要把这个正法带回中国。因此，我觉得怎么样能够把正法带回中国呢？我想最容易的。 就是把上人所讲的经典的诠释，把它带到中国，在中国呢来流通。所以，我们呢就把上人的经典诠释呢，用这个简体字带到中国呢来去流通。 当然，从开始的时候呢，这个经典遣释在中国流通呢，不是很容易。可是呢，也因为师父的法是正法，是真法，所以呢，出版了没多久呢，就流通得非常的广，甚至呢。 属于在中国呢，这个出版经书的销售率呢，达到头十名之一。阿弥陀佛， all Dharma masters and all good advisors and all good today I was told to give a talk about what I'm doing in China and what's the progress of what I'm doing in China. So maybe some of you don't understand why I have to do something about Shifu's Dharma in China. As a matter of fact, before Shifu went into Nirvana, he had told us to bring the proper Dharma back to China. So that's why this order from Shifu kept in my mind. But what can I do to bring the proper Dharma back to China? So I thought the easiest way is to bring Shifu's sutra with the sutra ledger with the commentary to publish it in China. Of course, because China only understands simplified characters. So we translate from the traditional characters into simplified characters and had it published in China. And when in the beginning, not too many people that really know about our publishings. But after it came out, all the sutra with Shifu's commentary came out, and our books were up to the top 10 sales in China. Now, in way, 除了这个 经书的销售之外, 由于这个科技越来越发达, 而且日新月异, 因此呢, 我们在中国有一般 对上人非常的尊敬的，非常的敬仰的年轻居士，他们就和我一起来做，跟着用这个新科技来参加这个，在中国现在也可以说是世界这个。 这个微信的公众号是属于第一的公众号，那所以呢，我们也加入这一个行程，我们从一个微信公众号，现在后来达到六个微信公众号，我们开始大概是 2-3万的月众一个月，后来达到600万的一个月的月众，所以呢，这都是我们在中国的一般很诚心的弟子来。 用心把这个公众号做出来的。Okay, after we published the books, and then because the technology is getting much advanced, so we thought we can try out and follow the footstep of technology. So we first joined in to have a WeChat site. In the beginning, we only have one WeChat site. And later on, we open up to about 6 WeChat sites. And from about 20,000-30,000 readers up to now, over 6 million readers a month. But unfortunately, 刚才没讲，但是呢，虽然我们是从一个微信公众号做到六个公众号，而且达到超过600万的阅众每个月，但是呢，因为我们的流量太大了，现在我们是被删除，被新的法规。被删除了五个公众号，只是给我们剩下一个公众号。不过我们呢，所有这班义工呢都没有气馁，因此呢，我们又出来了一些新的公众号了。Okay, because our volume is really big. Just our size already over 6 million readers a month. On top of that, there are others copy our articles and post it and circulate it. So actually, every month we had more than 6 million readers. So because of that, there is a new regulation. We could not have more than one site. Therefore, out of our 6 sites, 5 of our sites got take off because of the new regulation. Well, the reason they took off 5 of our sites because we all put it in under DRBA. And the new regulation, we cannot have more than one site by one organization. But in what I am going to do with over 6 million readers, so afterward, we decide and redesign some of the sites. 因为我们六个公众号呢被删除了五个了，所以呢，我们呢就想，我怎么样让这个600多万的人。能够继续看着我们所发布的师父的法呢，因此我们这些很诚心的义工，他们呢就帮我呢再重新我们再设计，因为新的法规呢只可以是一个机构只可以是一个公众号，所以呢，我们现在就化整为零。因此呢，我们又重新再来了新的法新的公众号了。Okay, Ivan, I don't think I can see the video. I mean the slides. Oh.Okay. 这都是呢我们在中国做的这个除了这个是App, 我们中文呢叫微网。这个微网呢是不管你是用苹果的手机或者用那个安卓的手机都可以用的。而且呢现在是只有简体字和正体字可以换的， 但是我们快要有一个新的、就是、可以呢包括有英文和中文的、繁体正体字简体字英文，还有呢 有其他的那个语言的、这个新的、微网呢希望是在今年的年底就会出来了、我们other than the、WeChat sites, we also have a DRBA app. This app、can be、changed from、traditional、character to simplified characters. And this is、an old one.And we're going to have an update one,、hopefully by the end of this year, the new、app will be out. And this new app will contain、much more information in the app, other than just Chinese、in the traditional character and、simplified characters. We also include English andMaybe some other foreign language, whatever、articles that we have、translated by DRBA BTTS, and、we will also post it in this app. 还有呢，除了这个、app 之外呢，我们还有一个 collective、cultivation、site.This is a global site,、this one, is the previous slide.、这个、yeah, this is the one. 这个、就是那个、全球共修平台。这个全球共修平台呢是、大家呢念这个楞严咒和大悲咒。我们定今年是第四年，我们定下了楞严咒呢是2000万的目标，然后大悲咒呢是8000万的目标。今年呢到8月31号呢就完成了。这个大悲咒呢这个目标8000万呢早就完成了。楞严咒呢也差不多了，所以我们参加在这个共修平台参加的人数呢是非常多，不光是居士，包括有很多法师都同样有参加我们这个全球共修平台。 Okay, the next one is the、collective cultivation, and、this is a global oneand also bilingual.、you have、Chinese and English.、and we cultivate、in reciting the Sarangama mantra and also the、Great Compassion mantra. We set the goal for、Sarangama mantra is 20 million.And the Great Compassion Mantra is 80 million. For the Great Compassion Mantra,、the goal is already、completed.、and the Sarangama Mantra、is going to be、reach the goal pretty soon.、this is the fourth year that we、have this、going on. And、August 31st is the last day for the, to complete the goal. Okay, next one. Next slide, please. Okay. I talked about the WeChat sites. 我刚才讲呢，这个微信公众号呢，本来是六个的。但是现在我们、把它转换了，所以呢 留下给我们的只有宣化上人国际法会。That is, 然后呢，我们现在新加的是妙觉堂上宣化上人，还有一个就是宣化上人1918。我们还把上人的法语放在抖音，因为现在抖音是非常的popular， 很流行啊。所以呢，这是我们最新加上来的。OK， from our six sites, they left us the Master Hua International. So, just this week, we added the Webby Shenhua, and also Shenhua 1918, two new sites. But this, we cannot put it all under DRBA, so we get smart now. And then we also just started to post our Dhammas in TikTok. As you all know, TikTok is a very popular site now, especially for the younger generation. But then we just launched it yesterday. And although we don't know the volume, how big the volume that we reached yet, but so far we published, I mean, we posted the Shifu's Dhamma talk, and then we put it into a very simple dialogue. So, 法语. Okay, 我们我刚才说的那个抖音哈，大家都知道，抖音现在是非常的流行。因此呢，我们也把宣化上人的法语做成了很短的，因为抖音都是要很短的。但是我们发觉呢，还是也有很多人会看这个抖音。我们是刚刚昨天才开始上这个抖音的。这里都是那个公众号还有上去找我们所发布的抖音就是XHSRFH。那这个其他那个呢，你在 WeChat 打这个号呢就可以了。大家都知道今年呢是师父涅槃26周年。我们所有在中国的义工呢，每年都会举办一些公益活动来纪念上人。我们的公益活动呢，就是本来是有这个video 的但是我不知道能不能看。不过总而言之啦，这个这里呢是在天津，我们举办的公益活动呢，就是赠送所有贫困的老人家这个免费的素餐，有的不能来的呢，我们就送给他，专人送给他们的，这个呢，我们每年都会举办两次。一次就是纪念上人的生日，一次呢就是纪念呢这个上人的涅槃纪念。你们现在看到这个呢，这是我们另外一个活动，公益活动，就是呢我们叫做陪读啊，在中国很流行这一个事情叫陪读。就是陪伴这些贫困的孩子没有父母的或者只有单亲的，但是因为他们上学呢，有很多时候呢没办法真的明白，所以呢我们有专门的义工去帮助他们来学习。 所以这个叫陪读。Okay, as you see a little while ago, we had the slide about the one of the our charitable activities. That was the one for the free meals for all these poor elders. And we do this every year. Two times a year. One time is to commemorate Shifu's birthday and also one time for his Nirvana Day. And this one is just yesterday. We did it and we serve about almost 300 meals to all these poor elders. And as you can see, they will come far away to get our meals. And this was done in Tianjin. We were lucky to have one of the Buddhist lay person. He let us use his restaurant, vegetarian restaurant in Tianjin. These are the stainless steel box that we also provide to some of those poor elders that don't have money to get a nice lunchbox. Okay, and then another activity we also do is in Jilin for helping the poor students. Some of them are orphans and some of them are just from the single family. So we help them. Actually, it's more or less like tutoring, except we're not teaching them anything, except we accompany them to study. So this is part of our activity in Jilin, Shifu's hometown province. Woman, Hayo, Yiga, Hodona, Jose, Yesu, Dai, Shifu, the 家乡吉林，就是呢，在也是赠送这个食品给这些贫困的老人。那个地方呢，因为吉林呢有很多地方呢都是在山区，在山区的地方呢，就很多人呢就没办法，尤其是贫困的老人，没办法呢能够买到食品。所以呢，我们也做这一个赠送这个食品，譬如说米啊、油啊，这些东西，还有他们所需要的日用品，这也是我们在中国的义工来做的。Another one, another activity we do in China is also we provide food stuff and necessities for the poor and elder people in the village of Shifu's hometown, Jilin. Over there, there are a lot of hillsides and mountain sides, you know. So there are a lot of the poor elders, they live over there, and it's very hard for them to get foodstuff. So we also deliver foodstuff to them, such as rice and oil, and also some necessities like blankets and those things. And that's our activities in China, other than we post all Shifu's Dharma and in books and in WeChat sites and in TikToks. Oh, now we even have ebooks in China for all Shifu's sutra lectures with commentary. Okay, 阿弥陀佛，希望
阿弥陀佛。 Appreciate your sharing with us, Madalena. These stories are very inspiring. And please, as soon as the app is ready, we want to know about that so people can gather all of the languages and all of the media into one place, and we can learn about Shifu's teachings worldwide. 那就 可能分享这些消息呢，请大家发心。那个等那个 app 出来了，我们想请 Madalena 又来跟我们分享这个消息了。那么那个 app 它的 APP 它的好处就是。 你去一个地方都可以有不同的语言啊，不可有正体字、繁体字、简体字，还有录音、录音，还有文字，那就是一个地方可以集中，那就是那个时候请Madalena回来，我们都可以大家可以找到这个app. Okay, our last speaker tonight is the representative from Male. Lay people, a layman, also representing youth. This is Alex Wong, who was resident at CTDB for, was it 3 years, I guess, and also a graduate of Dharmaram Buddhist University. And he has his own perspective on following the teachings of a Chinese master, even though he never saw him in person. So Alex has a lot to say to us tonight. Also, he's going to talk a little bit at the end about those of you who might be interested in contributing to our biography committee, a way that you can get in touch with us and we can know about your interest and your talents and your skills. So Alex will also share that, share his screen when that time comes. 好了，那我们就现在请 Alex Wong， 他住万佛城三年了，他是代表今天南居士，他是南居士其中一位，他也是法界佛教大学的毕业生。那么他讲完了他的心得以后，他就介绍，如果你们在线上，那么各位想参与。 想参加我们这个 biography committee 就有办法，他告诉我们怎么样可以证明，告诉我们你的有什么兴趣啊，你是不是有可以誊写中文誊写英文啊，或者你是有这个 video editing 这种的知识呢？ 就可以在一个表格上跟我们联络。 Okay, so sorry for my Chinese. My Chinese is very rusty. Let's invite Alex to take the screen and share with us his thoughts on today's 26th observance of Master Hua's Nirvana.
Okay. All Buddhas, Bodhisattvas, Venerable Master, Dharma Masters, and good and wise advisors, Amitabha. My name is Alex Wong, or disciple Qin Li, and it's an honor to be here today.
诸佛菩萨、上人、诸位法师、各位善知识们，阿弥陀佛。我的名字是 Alex Wong， 皈依名是清丽。我今天很高兴能出席这场纪念上人涅槃的讲座。So
first, I'd like to say that it's an enormous privilege to be able to speak to you all today. And that I'd like to invite everyone to please kindly correct me if there is anything that I say that doesn't accord with the proper Dharma. My role in this panel of esteemed speakers is to say a little bit about what it's like and what it means to me personally to contribute to the biography project as a relative newcomer to Master Hua's Dharma and to this community.
首先，我必须强调，这是一份莫大的荣幸。 能在这里跟大家交流，如果今晚我所说的有任何不如法的地方，我恳请大家慈悲指正。今天，我跟这群令人尊敬的法师们及长辈们同台，我的任务是想跟大家谈一谈 做一个法界佛教会的新成员，及学习上人的法的新成员，如何对宣公上人传法西方的传记上做出个人的贡献及努力。
So I think that important to get a clear idea about what it means to be part of this project as a young person in DRBA. It's important to share a little bit about what it is like hearing my first Venerable Master story. As someone who was and still is skeptical, arrogant, and thinks they know a lot more about the world than they actually do. Because obviously people already know everything they need to know by the age of 25. So the first real in-depth Venerable Master story that I heard was about the San Francisco Chinatown gangsters' first trip to the city of 10,000 Buddhas, where Venerable Master, after only just meeting them, scolded them in incredibly explicit detail regarding their killing, stealing, lying, carrying weapons, and so forth. And while it was an incredibly interesting story, I remember thinking, so here's the pitch of how your teacher is better than others and why I should follow DRBA. That, or this is a case of Chinese whispers that has gotten seriously out of hand. The reason that I thought this was that where I'm from, people like Venerable Master are only found in storybooks, Marvel movies, fiction novels, or in the New Testament. They're not people who come to the United States during the 60s to help hippies, gangsters, war veterans, and politicians turn over a new leaf to investigate their minds. The whole idea of a man who is totally selfless, without any greed, completely compassionate, and having omniscient wisdom was inconceivable. And the addition of spiritual powers and mind reading made the story even more far-fetched. If it weren't for the fact that the people who are telling me these stories were individuals whom I admired and who I considered believable, I probably would have immediately dismissed them and may not be here today.
So I want to express more clearly, as a new generation of Buddhists,到底参加上人传法西方的英文传记具有什么意义？之前我必须先跟大家简单分享一下，像我这样子一类的年轻人，对这个世界曾经并抱持着怀疑态度的人，自己以为对这个世界很了解，因为我只有25岁，事实上我完全对不了解这个世界到底怎么回事。所以当我们听到宣公上人的故事呢，到底有什么样的意义？这些是我自己个人的经验，但是我认为我的经验，并不是独一无二的，在座可能也会有同感。我听到的第一个故事呢，是关于上人，在旧金山唐人街的黑帮、黄青帮的一个故事。这些人呢，来到万佛城，上人见到这群帮派弟子、帮派分子，当下就直接斥喝他们。这些人以前做过的恶行，就包括就是偷拐抢骗，上人还痛骂他们携带武器等等。当然这是一个极度有趣的故事，我记得当时我看完那个故事，我心里想，这像是在跟我在推销上人是异于常人，似乎是在跟我叫卖这些特点，或是有人当传声筒讲得太夸张了。所以对我这个世代的人而言，宣公上人这种高僧大德的圣者呢，只存在于故事书之中，或是像功夫的电影里面，或是科幻小说，或是在新约圣经里。我压根不会想到像这样子的人会出现在美国的60年代，帮助当时的嬉皮，帮助黑帮改邪归正，帮助退伍军人、政治人物等，让这些人重新展开生命，并启发他们回光返照，研究他们自己的心。像这样子一个完全无私、 没有任何贪欲和完完全全慈悲无所不知的人竟然活在这个世界上，这是很令人震撼的。除此之外，这个人还有各种神通，还能读到别人心里想什么，种种故事使得宣公上人这个人更加的不可思议。还好当年讲这些故事给我听的人是我敬佩的人，所以我认为他们讲的有可信度，不然当时我可能听完就算了，那么今天我可能就不会站在这里跟诸位分享。
So, fast forward a few years. After sticking out long enough that some faith started to develop, these stories went from local myths to an anchor to the Dharma, which stopped me drifting off when life started providing other offers. And as evidenced by projects like the talks hosted by CTDB, the Water Shifu lecture series, and the Venerable Master Legacy Club's talks, others are also hungry for these stories. It's a way to stay inspired to practice and to overcome doubt in the Dharma through the living example of Venerable Master. But anyone who has spent any amount of time investigating these stories will know that because Venerable Master touched so many lives and with so many things to so many different people, that at best it's disorienting to try and imagine what he was truly like. And at worst, you end up cursing your karma for not having the opportunity to meet him and want to give up, thinking something like, the Hung and Guo generation had the benefit of having a teacher like Venerable Master. What hope is there for me?
现在让我转一下时间，回到几年前，当我逐渐发展对上人的信心和信仰，这些故事开始成为我生命中的苗的毛，帮助我跟佛法紧紧的连在一起。当我的妄想起来时，这些故事让我不会被拖入世间法，再去做那些好玩，但是会让人继续轮回的事。其中一个例子是在法界大学的宣公上人置业传承社之中，即我们谭居士我的师父上人老弟子的演讲系列。我看到很多人跟我一样非常需要听到这些故事来帮助我们，激励我们在道上修行。透过上人活生生的故事，这些故事也帮助我们解除很多修行上的疑惑和不确定。但是任何花大量时间研究这些故事的人都会知道，因为上人接触如此多人的生命，以及对如此多的人有产生不同的影响力，有各种不同的影响，所以充其量的尝试想象他的真实面貌是令人迷惑的。当然最坏的结果，你会因为没有机会见到他而咒骂你的业力，可能想要放弃。你会想像恒跟果自辈的上一代有上人这样的老师，那我还有什么希望呢？阿弥陀佛。
So, now to say how any of this relates to the biography project. I'm fairly new to the project, but what I've noticed so far is that the more time I spend listening to these stories, parables, and lessons,the more I'm able to trust and see the nuances of the messages that I've been told from day one about how to practice. Namely, dharmas like the six great principles, the three non-outflow studies, and the four boundless hearts. Because more than spiritual powers or magnificent acts of will, these are the qualities which the senior disciples who I've listened to seem to cite again and again.
所以这些跟上人传法西方的传记有什么关系呢？我刚接触到这个计划不久，但是当我花更多的时间研读和聆听这些故事、地狱 训诫等等，让我更坚信这些维系见解的意义与其差别。从第一天开始，我就被告知如何修行，譬如六大宗旨、三无漏学、四无量心，这些都是超过神通与一些不可思议的境界。这些都是我听到这些资深弟子们记得上人的教诲。阿弥陀佛。
And to directly address people who are in the same boat as me, it's worth saying that the current plan for the biography project is split into 8 phases, which I won't go into in any depth at the moment. But only 2 of these have the requirement of actually having a personal relationship with the Venerable Master, which means that there's a potential for young people to play a major role in completing the biography. And from another perspective, it also means that there is a really unique and rare opportunity for a large amount of people to develop a secondhand relationship with the Venerable Master by spending a concentrated amount of time studying the stories, facts, talks, photos, and videos of his life, while at the same time contributing to creating the same opportunity for people in 20, 30, 40, 50, 100, or 200 years down the road. And the last point which I'd like to make before sharing how people can express interest in working on the biography project is that the longer I've spent reading and listening to what it was like at the beginning of DRBA, the more I realize that even though people like myself didn't have the opportunity to know Venerable Master in the flesh, we do have the benefit of being able to enjoy the result of Venerable Master's and the senior generation's 60 plus years of hard work in growing the Sangha, building monasteries, translating the Tripitaka, developing all the different buildings, curriculums, and programs for Buddhist education in the West, developing relationships with teachers from other religions and traditions, and in making the Dharma abundantly accessible in the 21st century, which, if anything, is a great reason to feel gratitude and encouraged that cultivating the Tao is still something that's possible 26 years after Venerable Master's passing.
So, 就直接对我跟我相同的因缘在这同一条船上的众生而言，值得一提的是，在上人的传记计划之中有分八个阶段，当然时间很赶，没有机会跟诸位做仔细的介绍这八个阶段。在这个其中两个时期是需要跟上人直接接触的因缘，但是呢，从另外一个角度而言，上人的传记其实是要由年轻的晚辈来完成，因为其他的六个阶段呢，都是要年轻的下一辈来完成的。所以借着这个稀有特殊的机会，会让更广大的众生成就能够跟上人建立这间接的关系，借着花时间来研读上人的事迹、故事、开示、照片、录像等，也同时因此能够造就让未来的20年、30、40、50、100甚至200年后的众生同样有相同的机会。最后我可以做这样的结语，当我花更多的时间研读和聆听当时法界佛教会开始的时候是什么样子，我更了解到像我这样没有机会亲自见到上人，我们还是有机会被利益到由上人和第一代的早期弟子们胼手知足经过60多年的努力的成果，建立僧团、翻译经典、建立道场、佛教在西方的教育课程的训练、跟不同的宗教传统交流、丰富的佛法在这个21世纪，尤其是让我感到感恩鼓励，在上人涅槃20年之后修行了道还是可以实现的。阿弥陀佛。
So to finish up, I'm going to show you guys first, I'm going to put the link in the chat box for anyone that would like to express interest in the biography project. And that link will take you to this page, where at this point we're gauging interest and seeing how many people are interested in helping out. So you have just a few basic things of interest, information about yourself, what your available time is. If you have any relevant experience working in DRBA, like say in translating, if you're your educational history, more referring to what you've studied. So if you've done a bachelor's, a master's, or a PhD, if there's any jobs that you've held that would be, you think would be helpful to note, of say you've been a researcher or you've been a translator or something like that. What languages you speak and read, and just a few of the kinds of skills that may be needed for working in the biography project. So if you're interested, please feel free to let us know, and we'll get back to you as soon as we can. Thank you all. Amitofo.
再来呢，最后就是跟诸位分享，在我们的聊天室呢，我有放就是我们上人传法西方传记的一个报名表，一些简介的资料，所以在这个连接上面呢，你可以看得到，有你可以留下您的email 电子邮件，你的名字。如果你对来参与这个上人传法西方传记的这个计划有兴趣呢，都可以填下你的资料，譬如说你对什么是有兴趣的，然后你的一些基本的背景，譬如说你的教育背景是什么，是大学、研究所还是博士，然后你对什么样的计划呢是有兴趣想要帮助，譬如说你是想要做翻译呢，然后你对什么样的语言就是很了解，所以有这样子的技术能够来做一些资料的整理的工作。所以如果您有兴趣想要参加这个计划呢，欢迎您就是把你的资料留下来，然后我们之后会再跟您联络。 OK， 感恩大家，阿弥陀佛。
阿弥陀佛。So that concludes our program. We ran over time, but I think the resources and the content were very rich. So we're going to conclude with the transference of merit. And I want to express appreciation to all the volunteers who make these lectures possible. The translators like Alan and the laymen who work on the technical side, and also the Sangha for supporting this work. 就说我们到此为止，我们是过时间了，可是呢，内容丰富，希望各位都可以身体健康，精神愉快，感恩所有义工帮我们能完成今天晚上的讲解。那么我现在 share my screen， 我们最后有回向功德。Please put your palms together. Let's put our hearts together and transfer the merit. Stay healthy, stay peaceful and serene in your spirit. Let's transfer the merit. Here we go. May every living being, our minds as one and radiant with light, share the fruits of peace with hearts of goodness, luminous and bright. If people hear and see how hands and hearts can find in giving unity, may our minds awake to great compassion, wisdom, and to joy. May kindness find reward. May all who sorrow leave their grief and pain. May this boundless light dispel the darkness of our endless night. Because our hearts are one, this world of pain turns into paradise. May all become compassionate and wise. May all become compassionate and wise. Now we'll conclude with three bows to the Buddha. Bow in respect to the Venerable Master. Hello. 功德圆满,大家阿弥陀佛, good night everyone.
If people are now in a hurry to leave, I have a couple announcements. 如果你不急着要走的话, 我这边有两个, 公告, 让大家晓得。 The first one is next Sunday, we have three students from DRPU's translation certificate program, and they share their experience, their reflections. 下礼拜天同样这个时间是法界大学经典翻译学程的学生，三位学生要和我们分享他们的学习心得。那个 Zoom 的link和今天的是一样，YouTube 的我们会再提供给大家。So the same Zoom link as today's. And YouTube link will provide that later. Another thing is that you probably know that the CDB, we have Avatam Sutra recitation going on, starting this today. And so it's going to be for until the 8th of July. 也许你晓得那个温伯承现在从今年开始是在送华严经。 那回到7月8号, this is a schedule from Sunday to Friday, just quickly. In the morning, it's 7 to 8 is Chinese recitation. 8 to 10 is the English. In the afternoon is Chinese again. 那这个星期天到星期五,早上7点到8点是中文, 然后8点到10点这是送英文。 下午1点到3点,05这个又是送中文。 And the link is the same as our usual Dharma events, like Saturday or the sessions, the same link. 那这个Zoom的link是和一般我们法会的连接一样,和今天晚上是不一样。 So it's different from this evening's lecture, it's different. And Saturday is Chinese only. And there's no English recitation on Saturday. 星期六是只有中文的诵经, 没有英文的, okay? So much for that. And we appreciate Reverend Hensher and all the speakers. It's a wonderful evening. 很感激司法师还有所有的演讲的人给我们一个很丰盛的晚上。 阿弥陀佛，
阿弥陀佛，金庸师，阿弥陀佛。Good night.
Good night.